Sky pilot.
Craig, Denny, was kind enough to talk to this old guy here, and what he saw was my Navy hat. Let's see if I can get it in there. USS Fisk. Well, anyway, that's why Craig started off right in talking about the Navy. Here's a through hiker and a good man.
Flying helicopters. Was a warrant officer.
Whereabouts?
Canto, that was in the Delta. That was the provincial capital of the Delta. Canto, Vietnam.
Yeah.
I'm from Florida. Started on the trail 4 days ago, tired. Oh, God.
Well,
your first week's a killer, you know?
That's what I was going to ask you. Were you doing the long trail?
No. I'm doing the AT. Wow. This is my third section. I did 800 miles in 08, and I got to just below the Shenandoah. And then I did 800 miles in 09, and they let me out at Highway 9 down here by Bennington.
Wow.
And I started there 3 days ago.
Wow.
This is my fourth day, so. Takes a guy my age about 8-9 weeks to get in shape. 7 to 8, accurate. The young kids do it in 5.
Right.
And then, you know, they're off like a flash. You never see them again, you know.
Well, that's what they tell me, that the trail will get you in shape.
Yeah, it gets you in shape, and then if you're probably past 60, at a point it starts breaking you down, and you can't recover. Now, it's not saying that you can't. The oldest man to ever through hike the trail, walk it all the way, was 85.
Yeah, it's pretty relevant.
And the oldest woman's 83. The women and the men are equal on this trail.
Oh, sure.
Yeah.
And age is
everything.
Well, yes and no. I guarantee you there are kids in their 20s who could not do this.
They say they can't, but if they're average health and average everything, after 5 weeks, they're 15, 20 miles a day. You know, they're just like a flash. But me, I get up to about 11, 12 miles a day. So, and that won't get you there in one season. You got to do like 14. So.
Do you have a trail name?
Sky Pilot.
Oh, yeah?
I flew Cobras in Vietnam. And somebody said, oh, my God, you flew Cobras. You saved my ass, dude. Well, I wasn't there at the time. But
Right.
But that's the way,
you're all,
that's
yeah.
The way grunts thought of.
It was people like you saved my ass.
Oh, yeah. That's what grunts thought of Cobra pilots, because it brought so much firepower. We could put more firepower on a point target in 6 seconds than a battalion of artillery could in an hour.
Wow.
Wow, yeah. And the machine gun was like 66 bullets a second. A second.
Yeah, it's hard to
electric
imagine.
Motor Gatling gun, you know. 52 rockets.
And how old are you?
I'll be 66 in 2 weeks.
Wow.
How about you?
Well, I'm 69, and I really don't think I could do the trail.
Oh, there's a guy up ahead of me here. He's walking ahead of me today. He's 73. He's got about 2-3 more weeks on me, so he's in better shape. And
wow.
73. He's got pinched nerves and all kinds of things wrong with him, but, you know, it gets in your blood and you don't want to stop. That's the.
Could I put this on YouTube?
Sure.
Okay, yeah.
Craig Denny is my name. I live in Florida. Chad is a whisk of Florida. A little village, 300 wow. people. About an hour north of Tampa, okay. On the Gulf side. Yeah.
Why are you doing the trail? Or don't you know?
It's there to do. it's such a grand, grand adventure that you just can't help yourself. It's just amazing, amazing. You know what it does to your body, you can't believe. Before it wears you out, your blood pressure's down to like 117 over 57. I mean, it's just, really? It hasn't been that since high school, you know. But if you don't eat salty foods and things and you're doing 10 miles a day carrying a 35-pound pack, man, does it. And you realize that's what humans are made to do, is walk. That's what we're bipeds. We're upright. We're much healthier walking than we are sitting. So.
Well, you know, talking to each one of you is really an inspiration. I probably talked to half a dozen this year.
Cool.
Last year, about 10 or 12. And it's really an inspiration, but it's a hell of a commitment.
Yeah, you have to buy about $1,400 worth of equipment to get to lightweight modern gear, and you'll spend another couple thousand on the trail, because you got to stay at a hotel some night. You got to wash once a week at least, wash your clothes, get your food dropped. My food's mailed to me. I really walk from post office to post office. But in this case, Johnny Seesaw's Lodge took my package, and I'll stay there for a couple of days and recover. And they'll give me my food package, and I'll repack my pack and head out of town.
Wow.
Yeah, it's pretty cool how you do it once you get the hang of it.
You're a good man.
I'm average on the trail.
Craig, was that your first
name? Yeah. Craig Denny, like Denny's restaurant.
Yeah.
Craig Denny, yeah.
Unbelievable. I keep saying that to everyone that I talk to because it's awesome to me.
Yeah,
what
it's an
you're doing.
Awesome adventure. Really, you just can't believe it. My sons are going, I can't believe you're doing this. Look what you're making me do. You know, their mother just got a doctorate, and I'm walking the AT. And what do we got to do? Yeah. When do you get past a doctorate? How do you walk past the AT? So, you know. Yeah. There's a Boy Scout troop coming behind me here. They're from Illinois, too. They'll be here in 20 minutes, maybe.
Yeah. Well,
about 10 boys and 3 leaders.
And they're coming from where?
They're coming behind me here. They're just doing a week.
Yeah, I got you.
And some of the other half is coming down to the next, where Johnny Seesaw's is. What's that town called?
I don't know where Johnny Seesaw's, but there's a
something center.
Manchester Center is the next
center.
One up.
That's where it is. They come and pick you up from there. You call them from the trail, and they'll come pick you up. And give you a rate. A lot of people give you rates when you're on the trail.
Oh.
You know, so.
Are you keeping a journal or anything?
Yeah, I keep a journal.
A written journal?
A written journal, and I take pictures. And once a week, I send the wife a letter, and I go over my diary that I've made, and I write her a letter out of that diary. It's the strange things you see. I'm coming up the trail out of Bennington. I wasn't. The first day, I wasn't an hour up on the trail. And all of a sudden, I hear somebody coming up behind me. And I turn around, and here's a man wearing a straw hat, shoes, and a butt pack. You know what a butt pack is? Yeah. I should say, that's all he was wearing.
Oh.
He was letting it all hang out on the Appalachian Trail.
You know? I thought you were going to say he was a through hiker with
no,
just that. But
no, he was naked as a jaybird, and all he was wearing was his hat and shoes and his butt pack.
Wow.
I told him, I've gone 1,600 miles and I ain't seen nothing like this. There's a car coming up behind us.
Yeah. But no, it's, I got you captured here, Craig, and, you know, if you see it online, I just put it on Appalachian Trail 2011 Sky Pilot, and then you might be able to find it, or if you go to my website on YouTube, is just Who and Sam Hill will bring up all the stuff I put. Anyway, it'll be there, and then you can email me if you want, if you want a full, you know, DVD or something with high def. I don't know how high def this is. I forgot
to
reset it.
I don't even own a computer, so I can't email it. You say it's on Appalachian Trail 2011? Is that
and yes, and then Sky Pilot.
And then Sky Pilot.
Because there's a lot of them in there.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
And Sky Pilot. Okay, thank you. I got friends with computers. I'll tell them to look it up. Thank you very much. What's your name?
Mike Coughlin.
Mike Coughlin. Nice to meet you, Mike Coughlin.
Yeah, later.
Pleasure, sir. Well, I wonder where the trail goes from here.
Yes.
You have to cross this bridge?
Yeah, right on the other side of the bridge.
On the other side of the bridge.
Parking lot there, and then the sign.
Well, 3.6, I've gone. What time is it, you know?
Yeah. 9:22.
9:22. Okay, 3 hours. Not quite 3 hours.
Oh, you got up early, okay.
Oh, I'm the first one. I'm always the first one to leave camp. Always. I get up first crack of dawn, maybe 4:50. I woke up this morning and I eat, downpack and everything, and I'm off by 6:30. So it's taken me a little longer to get going in the morning because I haven't got my routine down, but that won't take long.
Wow. Well, I'll walk down with you. I'm going back anyway. I was just going up to here, turn around and do my morning walk.
Yeah, you live near here?
No, I'm a wanderer and I'm camped down here in Grout Pond, just a mile and a half down the road here.
I've got an Alaskan camper on the back of a big GMC truck. When I'm not on the trail, then the wife and I go out for 6 months a year and pick a spot and go out and stay in the area. New Mexico, I got grandkids there. We did Alaska one summer. Just things I wanted to see all my life. I never had the time or the money to do it. And good old dad helped me out there. He died of asbestos.
Wow.
Asbestos cancer. Killed him.
Yeah.
He was a big, strong dude. Took him down at 84. I mean, he took him down smaller than me.
Oh, my
when he
gosh.
Got, he was 5'10". He shrunk down to about, you know, he was 5'10 and a half. He shrunk down a little bit. And he weighed 230 pounds. And 2 years later, he was smaller than me. It's hard to believe.
Yes.
Oh, that's what I heard, that.
Well, I watched my brother do the same thing.
Asbestos just shrink. Cancer?
No, he has Alzheimer's, but you just shrank away to nothing.
Yeah.
I mean, to just a small,
lose
and he was
mind,
two or three inches taller than I was.
Hello.
Hello, hey.
Hi.
Hi.
You got a minute for this guy? You put you on.
Huh?
I'm Mike Coughlin, and I'm just doing this to keep a collection of people I've talked to that are hiking.
Oh, okay.
Do you have a trail? It's a video.
You can look it up online with Appalachian Trail 2011, and then your trail name. What's your trail name?
I'm Rock Monkey.
Pleasure. Mike Coughlin.
Nice to meet you.
And how are you doing?
He's a true hiker.
Good. Well, I didn't start in Georgia. I started in Harper's Ferry. But I'm going north first, and then I'll go back to Harper's Ferry and go south. So.
Wow.
I'm a flip-flopper.
See you later, Craig. Sky pilot.